Hi, good people. I'm just quickly gonna show you how I bypassed my bt-50 2.2. This is how I did my water pipes. This is the pipe that is coming from the heater core inside. The old pipe was coming from here. I just cut it here. The old pipe was coming from here, going straight to the cooler, to the water cooler of the EGR cooler. And then another pipe was coming from somewhere there and then into the EGR housing. So what I did is I just cut the pipe from the EGR cooler and then I joined it here with this pipe, and then I took it straight to the EGR housing there. Can't see properly. Straight to the EGR housing there. And then the one that's coming from the EGR cooler to the housing, I carried it and joined it with this one here. Let's see. Check. Yeah, here is it. And the old pipe, it's somewhere there, here. I just blocked it with something there. So that is how I bypassed my water pipe for my EGR. So the pipe is coming from here, cut this pipe, joined it with this one, cable clamped the other one, the old one, joined it with this one, and then it goes straight. When I get to this side, I cut the one that is coming from the EGR cooler to the EGR housing, and then joined it with this pipe here. I'm still gonna put it nice. I just left it hanging here to show you guys how I bypassed my EGR water system, my EGR cooler water system. Yeah, and then what I did was I then installed a planking plate on the EGR there. I think you can see the here. Where is it? Okay, I just need the right angle. If you can check there on the EGR, this is the EGR, and then this is the housing. This is a pipe that is coming from that is joined, and then to the housing, and then to the water system or to the oil cooler. And then the blanking plate, I installed it there. I just can't get the right angle there. I installed the blanking plate there. You can see my finger where it's pointing. If you check nicely, I just got something to point, because my hands are too big, I can't show you while I'm pointing with my hands. If you check there, there's a bolt there, the top bolt, and then there, the bottom, there's a bottom bolt there. And then here, this angle, this is where the EGR blanking plate goes in. You just loosen the bolt up there, and then you loosen the bottom one. You just slide it in, and then you tighten them. Make sure that they are tight, and make sure that the seal that is inside there is at the side of the exhaust, and then you install you slide in your blinking blade on the side of the EGR housing. Make sure that the seal is on the exhaust or the EGR cooler side. And then this is how I did it. If you check there, there's a top bolt there, you can just barely see it. And then there's another one at the bottom there. Just it's too dark now. That's how you install, or that's how you will slide in your blinking plate. And then this is the EGR itself. This one here, this is the EGR, and then this is my EGR housing. This pipe here, the pipe that is here, this one is the pipe that is coming from the EGR. Is the pipe that is coming from the EGR to, it's coming from the EGR to the intake pipe here. It's the pipe that is coming from the EGR to the intake. It takes the EGR bend or exhaust fume gases. Let me say that. Exhaust gases back to the system of the engine, back into the intake, mixing with the fresh oxygen air into your cylinders. That is why you'll get you find that your engine on the intake system is very, very, very dirty due to those exhaust gases mixing with the oil coming from your intercooler, your PCV valve into your intercooler and then into your intake system. When those exhaust gases are mixing with that oil, they create a very, very bad sludge on your intake. It's blocking your intake. So by doing this, your engine will be much, much more happier. You'll save more fuel, you'll get no exhaust gases back into your intake or into your cylinders, and then your engine will run on fresh air only. So you'll see much, much more better fuel economy on that. Although it's illegal in the other countries, but yeah, your fuel economy will be better, your performance will be better, because remember, those exhaust gases, they are dirty. So you'll be getting much more cleaner air into your engine or into your cylinders, so your engine will run much more better. So yeah, thank you guys. I think this will be helpful.